was final, and it was the finality of it that was so unbearable. Even with the technology we were creating, there was no way of reaching back into time to save her. We were moving forward, relentlessly. The days flying by, and with every day, Miranda was further away. I think that was the first time I really understood what it means that time is a dimension. I could measure the distance between us in minutes, hours, days, years. But if what broke Athena was accepting that distance, for me, it was the opposite. I refused to accept it. The universe had already taken so much from us. It didn't get to take my daughter. except that my daughter was gone. Her body was destroyed, obliterated. But we're more than just a body. We're a pattern, a melody in ones and zeros. And I was convinced that somewhere, somehow, that melody still existed. I just couldn't believe that it didn't. I refused to. That thought consumed me. In some ways, it broke me. But I didn't give up. Not every obsession has to be fought, you know. The easy way isn't always the right one. and I were so consumed by our obsessions that we stopped being able to communicate. We loved each other, but Miranda's ghost hovered over every conversation. That kind of grief annihilates you. You can't ever be the same person again.
Thank you.
I hid the truth. Not just about Athena and the island, but everything. My grief. My personal opinions about where the city was headed, all of it. I became the dusty old curator people wanted me to be. Except, of course, that the whole thing was a front. I didn't care about the museum, and I certainly didn't care about the archive scholars and their endless, tedious discussions, no matter how much they fawned over me. No. What I needed was access to the tools. Studying the archive hasn't answered any of our questions about humanity, but it has taught us something. And that's data recovery.
You